be seated. Students, family, and friends, it is my distinct honor to welcome you to the Class of 2026 White Coat Ceremony. For those of you who have not had yet the pleasure of meeting, my name is Lauren Cobbs, and I am the Associate Dean for Student Affairs in the School of Medicine. As many of you know, the white coat is one of the most powerful and enduring symbols of the healthcare professions in general, and physicians in particular. Today, we are happy and proud to officially present our new students with their first white coats as part of welcoming you into the profession of medicine and our School of Medicine community. I'd now like to introduce the members of our platform party and faculty in attendance. Please stand as your name is called. Dr. Felix Morales, Associate Dean of Admissions. Dr. Ebtisam Islam, Associate Dean for Clinical Education. Dr. Sam Campbell, Assistant Dean for Clinical Sciences Curriculum. Dr. David Trotter, Assistant Dean for Student Affairs. Dr. Simon Williams, Senior Associate Dean for Academic Affairs. Dr. Robert Salem, Founding Vice Dean of Medical Education, Covenant Campus. Dr. John De Toledo, Vice Dean for Administration and Community Development. Dr. Darren D'Agostino, Provost and Chief Academic Officer for Texas Tech University Health Sciences Center. Dr. Stephen Burke, School of Medicine Dean and Executive Vice President for Clinical Affairs of Texas Tech University Health Sciences Center. And the faculty of the Texas Tech University Health Sciences Center School of Medicine, will you please stand? Thank you so much for joining us today. Everyone, please be seated. It is now my pleasure to welcome Dr. Stephen Burke to the podium to convey his remarks to our new class. Before doing so, I would like to share a few things about our school's highly accomplished dean. Dr. Burke graduated from Boston University School of Medicine and completed his internal medicine and infectious disease training at Boston City Hospital. He's the Executive Vice President for Clinical Affairs for the Texas Tech University Health Sciences Center and has served as Dean for our School of Medicine since 2006. A professor of medicine and family medicine, Dr. Burke's extensive career in academia spans more than 40 years, initially beginning at the College of Medicine at East Tennessee State University before he came here to join us at Texas Tech University Health Science Center School of Medicine about 23 years ago. Board certified in geriatric medicine, infectious diseases, and internal medicine, Dr. Burke is a highly well-respected leader and medical educator, the recipient of multiple teaching awards and other accolades, including Laureate in Medicine from Tennessee College of Physicians, a Headliner Award from the City of Lubbock, a C. Frank Weber Award from the Texas Medical Association, and Boston University School of Medicine's Outstanding Alumnus Award. Dr. Burke is also the author of more than 120 peer-reviewed articles, 5 textbooks, and many book chapters. His own book, Anatomy of a Kidnapping, A Doctor's Story, one of the gifts you receive from the Dean's Office at the Student Org Fair on Wednesday, hope everybody gets to chapter 2 by Tuesday, is his own very personal account of surviving an abduction from his home in Amarillo, and it has received the Book of the Year Award for True Crime in 2011. Dr. Burke has served in leadership roles for the Association of American Medical Colleges and the Texas Council of Deans, including serving as long-standing chair of the Texas Council of Deans for about 13 years now. And though I could truly go on and on about this well-accomplished physician, I will instead choose to conclude this introduction by acknowledging those parts of Dr. Burke's life that may be a little less well-known, but are nonetheless equally notable accomplishments. Married to Mrs. Burke for more than 41 years, or at least 41 years at this stage, this October, Dr. Burke is also the proud father of two sons, one of whom is a School of Medicine graduate from the class of 2015. He's also granddad to two very adorable granddaughters. So without further ado, please welcome Dr. Burke.
Welcome, class of 2026, family members and guests. Thank you to the Dean's Ambassadors for being here and to our faculty representatives. I'm so glad to be here with you today and celebrate my 17th white coat ceremony as a dean. But after a 2005 kidnapping, a heart attack with a five-vessel bypass, and as of yesterday, acute episode of sciatica, I'm glad to be anywhere today and be standing on my feet. Class of 2026, congratulations on becoming a medical student at Texas Tech Health Science Center School of Medicine. You were chosen from a pool of over 5,000 applicants, and we rarely make mistakes in assessing who has the potential to be an outstanding physician. Over 50 years ago, when the school began, many across the state did not believe there should be a medical school in West Texas. Politicians, deans of other medical schools, because they believed we did not have the population density, academic foundation, or infrastructure. Now, 53 years later, Texas Tech School of Medicine has a long-standing record of student satisfaction and student success. Among the highest USMLE pass rates, 99%, and one of the most affordable medical schools in the country based on tuition, cost of living, and availability of scholarships. Medical students are highly rated as first-year residents by residency program directors around the country. Our research program has expanded rapidly, and our students are ranked in the top 40% of schools based on their research accomplishments. Our Texas Tech Physicians Practice is among the 15% of medical schools, top 15% of medical schools based on the AAMC financial analysis. And we've received multiple awards on all campuses for patient care. So who is the lucky class of 2026? These students come from 42 different schools. The most, of course, from Texas Tech, 70, UT Austin, 21. 70-21, that sounds like a great future football score. I don't think the 21 from UT Austin were clapping, but UT Dallas, 13, Texas A&M, 11, Baylor, 6, Abilene Christian, 4, and from the farthest northwestern part of the state, Brigham Young, 6. The class has an average GPA of 3.85. 8 will be joining the Family Medicine Accelerated Track, the most innovative program in the United States to train primary care physicians, a program that has helped us be among the top 10 MD medical schools in producing family physicians. 15 are doing the MD-MBA degree, unique in that it's a four-year program. 10 the MD-MPH, 4 MD-PhD, and 5 in the new MD-PhD engineering program. In the first class of Texas Tech School of Medicine in 1974, there were 33 men and 3 women. The class of 26 has 88 women, and now there are almost exactly equal 360 men and 360 women in the current 4 classes of our medical school. ...166 students are from the state of Texas, and 101 from West Texas. Only about 26 students are married at the last count. So I predict, from 16 years experience as the dean, that some of you are going to marry each other. If you're single, there's a good chance your spouse is in the room right now, so be on your best behavior. And I'm proud that one of my duties as the dean is to help perform wedding ceremonies for medical students in case you decide to walk down the aisle in the next 4 years. It's pretty easy to get accredited these days for that. This is a diverse and accomplished group. Remember, their overall GPA is 3.85. The class includes students who are high school valedictorians. Their award list includes national merit finalists, Division I academic all-state teams, and academic all-state conference. Military awards for this class include Global War on Terrorism Service Medal, National Defense Service Medal, and Navy Marine Corps Achievement Medal. Previous occupations, and many of our students have done things way past the time that they graduated from college. Baristas, ranch hands, construction workers, teachers, music instructors, assistant baseball coach, volleyball coach, full-time missionary, firefighter, private pilot, licensed attorney. Two students were congressional interns in the U.S. House of Representatives, and one student interned as a U.S. Senator from Arkansas. Students with previous occupations in medical-related fields included several nurses, EMTs, a pharmacy school graduate, pharmacy techs, scientists, and our own School of Medicine optometrist. Accomplishments in athletics: students played in varsity college baseball, football, golf, rugby, tennis, soccer. We had a former captain of their college polo team and a member of the TTU Goin' Band from Raiderland. Colored belts in Kwando, Jiu-Jitsu, and Krav Maga, and karate. We have a tradition of good athletes in the medical school, and last year the School of Medicine won the Texas Tech University Flag Football Championship. In music and arts, this class is gifted in many different areas of music and arts, playing almost every known instrument, as well as an orchestra concertmaster. There are members of dance teams, including Bollywood, folk, tap, and ballet, and a comedian who writes his own material. Whomever that is, writing jokes, I do have some work for you. Other accomplishments of interest: some of the class has participated in medical missions, volunteered with many organizations, including Texas Tech Free Clinic. One student was a child actor during her toddler years, and another student is a former bass player for the country group Spur 327, which won the Texas Country Music Award Song of the Year for their song My Caroline. But also within this class, there is a different type of student that I want you to tell you about. Some who were not at the top of the class, who didn't get into medical school after the first try, or the second, or even the third. They worked other jobs, raised children, and some did extra years of graduate work, but they never gave up their dream of coming to medical school. Their determination, persistence, and diligence inspire us, and we take special pride in the successes of this group, along with the achievements of all of our students. Now, my message to the class, to my 17th class at your white coat ceremony. Your white coat today means that you have been invited into a prestigious profession, one where you will be a trusted participant in the most profound elements of human life, birth, renewal, cure, survival, rehabilitation, but also decline, insanity, pain, sorrow, and death. Very few are permitted to take this journey that you are beginning. You have been granted communion with life's most important trials and mysteries. Artists, poets, and priests may see and experience what you see, but they lack the scientific tools that you will begin receiving, gifts to change people's lives, to cure disease and alleviate suffering. You will learn to appreciate man's vulnerabilities, but also his nobility and transcendent spirit. You will have endless options to choose from. Go to the CDC to study monkeypox, to a small town in West Texas, or to Hollywood to do plastic surgery. You alone will make the choice, and wherever you go, you will be highly respected and paid well. But you will also have great responsibility, the responsibility that comes with a noble profession, those responsibilities which you accept today in your oath, to hold sacred the physician-patient relationship, protecting privacy and autonomy, to be honest with patients about options and mistakes and shortcomings, to care for all patients, even the most vulnerable, and to respect and understand cultural diversity, to commit to a lifelong pursuit of excellence in learning and acquiring scientific knowledge, clinical skills, and the capacity for compassion, to respect colleagues and to recognize the need for teamwork in today's healthcare system. Tomorrow, you will receive a stethoscope engraved with a double T that I hope will be symbolic, a commitment to listen carefully, to listen to the body for clues to disease, but also to listen to your patient with focus and intensity and patience, and to listen to your colleagues who become members of your team. Our traditional advice to develop an incredible work ethic and intensity to succeed is tempered these days with the admonishment to stay physically and mentally healthy, to remember who got you here. If you see a turtle on a fence post, you know it didn't get there by itself. Continue to cultivate the love of your family and friends who helped you settle on this fence post today. 4 years of medical school is too long a journey to go alone. You all have more than enough ability to do well in medical school when life goes your way. But when life throws a challenge, an illness, a death in a family, a breakup of a girlfriend or boyfriend, that's when success demands resiliency. And our deans and staff are here for you should that challenge arise. So for those of you who have worked so hard, long hours in the library, missing or at Starbucks, missing chances to come home so as to study for a test, missing a friend's wedding or a sibling's recitals, passing up those great courses given by hard graders, worrying incessantly about MCAT scores, make the most of this monumental moment to see this opportunity now open before you in a medical school that is so devoted to students. Class of 2026, the sun is always shining here in West Texas, and today is your day, your place, your time. Faculty, staff, and family members, please join me in congratulating the class of 2026. Your white coat ceremony, your medical career starts now.
Oh my God. Gayatri Aluri and Jennifer Ajay Mosey. Ali Ulhuk and Jack Allen. Ashlyn Anderson and Adam Baker. Shreya Balamurali and Rushil Balkundi. Vishal Bandaru and Joseph Bayuth. Mark Bazemore and Orr Belkin. Sai Pranathi Bingi and Elise Bolin. Matthew Boomer and Kelsey Brock. Luke Brockbank and Caroline Campbell. Ellie Cannon and Caitlin Chapman. Hannah Chowdhury and Tristan Chowdhury. William Chen and Junior Clark. Cade Crump, and Stephen Daly. Sean Daly and Rachel DeGroot. William Derrick and Cooper Dupree. Mitchell DeVolder and Eloise DT. Alistair Disraeli and V. Doe. Alexander Dorius and Jackson Driscoll. Caitlin Dunham and Jaina Eckert. Jacob Evans and Caroline Finney. Sina Feruzbach and Riley Fortner. Frank Frankowski and Avery Garcia. Jocelyn Garcia and Ricardo Isaiah Garcia. Yeah. Camille Gavin and Isaiah George. Heidi Gonzalez and Colby Gordon. Adithi Govindan and Benjamin Griff. Austin Guadarrama and Christian Gutierrez. Ali Hagaz and Nicholas Hancock. Anna Claire Henderson and Alex He. Christian Hernandez and Monica Hintz. Joey Holzer and Sarah Neal Horn. Hao-Ting Huo and Ismail Jabari. Suyush Jain and Madeline Jansen. Delaney Jensky and Conrado Jimenez. Kathan Singh Jolly, and Rebecca Joseph. Travis Kastner and Bradley Kent. Sachi Kemka and Asta Kiani. Nathaniel Kimball and Sahithi Kohli. Akash Kothari and Jennifer Kraybacher. Kylan Kuslak and Catherine Lakey. Gabriella Lamantier and Colton Lanning. Connor Larson and Benjamin Lasota. Noah Lee and Haley Luzzi. Ziyang Lee and Maxwell Lidstone. Paul Lee and Paige Livingston Lopez. Caitlin Lowry, and Robert Madden. Matthew Mahek and Tanuj Mahendro. Akash Maheshwari and Avantika Mullick. Kyle Mangum and Caitlin Mateka. Mary Matthew and Hayden Matthews. Grace McCree and David McDaniel. Brittany McEwen and Virginia McGrath. Megan McElvain and Barrett Meeks. Kaylin Mears and Aaron Milliken. Gintry Millsap and Ben Mitchell. Emily Mitchell and Crystal Morton. Megan Murchison and Amber Nanny. Yeah! Michelle Nguyen and Maryam Niazi. Angelica Nebo and Elliot Norman. Vasta Ogu and Erica Orlov. Jackie Orapaza and Kai Pascal. Shivam Patel and Shruti Patel. Rohan Pense and Gabrielle Plata. Caroline Presson and Grace Purcell. Ross Radicky and Andres Rios. Ali Rizvi and Jalen Robertson. Emily Rook and Hassan Saleh. Zach Salter and Taylor Sanders. Marlon Sandoval Hernandez and Delaney Sowers. Kyle Schnell and Muniza Sheikh. Colton Shepherd and Guel Simiu. Ezra Smith and Suash Srivastava. Varshini Suresh and Neeti Swami. Sophie Talbot and Caitlin Tayag. Grant Tekel and Brett Thigpen. Brevin Thompson and Hassan Tinwala. Anhul Jobar Janas and Vivi Tran. Shraddha. Trehan and Kayla Turner. Destiny Ugwa and Musafa Ula. Chase Van Riper and Nicholas Wagner. Andrew Wagner and Colton Wagnon. Zoya Wahid and Larson Walker. Garrett Welch and Luke Welchel. George Wiest and Jake Weilman. Allison Willis and John Wolpert. Colby Wood and Aaron Woodard. Abdallah Yazadi and Lucy Yu. Ferris Satoni and Charles Zhu. Lamia Zuberi, and Mohammed Sharif.
Ladies and gentlemen, I am proud to present Texas Tech School of Medicine's Class of 2026. Instead of the Hippocratic Oath, the class has written their own student oath, which they will now recite, led by Dr. Cobbs.
With please be seated.
I wanted to remind students and family that we have the Scopes and Scrubs party starting at 10 a.m. tomorrow at the University Center on campus. And immediately following the close of this ceremony, You can meet up with your medical students in the front lobby here and also visit with the School of Medicine faculty. Thank you all for being here.
Hold on to me as we go, as we roll down this unfamiliar road. And although this wave is stringing us along, just know you're not alone, 'cause I'm gonna make this place your home.